Hi, I'm Erwin Parra. I'm application specialist here at Fluke Calibration, and I'm gonna show you how to use the 5560A multi-product calibrator. Let's calibrate a DMM, in this case an 87.5 in DCV. So first, I need to check the connections. They are ready. Green lights, voltage connection. And I get 1 volt. Seems to be good. Next point, let's pretend that I have to do 2V. And I need to follow all the manual points. So now I'm calibrating 40 volts. Need to check that 40 volts there, get my numbers. If you notice, this light turns on, means that that is potential dangerous. Be careful, use the protection. 100 volts, DC. I get my indication that it's dangerous. 100 volts, we're good. And then I'm be done with DCV. Now I'm gonna jump to ACV. In this case, I don't need to change the cables. So 1 volt, 60 hertz, enter. And then I need to change my knob to ACV. I got 1, you need to wait to stabilize. And then same process that I did in DCV, jump to the calibration point that the manufacturer indicates. Let's change the frequency. Yeah, 1 volt. Let's do 120. And 60 hertz. Careful, 120, looks good. Now when I'm done with ACV, I need to jump to resistance. So, same post here, I need to change the knob. Now I'm doing 12 ohms, getting 12. This is resistance in this case, 2 wire in this case. 100 ohms, and I'll be continuing doing all the calibration steps that I need to do according to the manual. And then I'm done with resistance, I need to stop and change the connections because I'm gonna do current. So 1 amp, don't do it now, wait, you need to change the connections here. Now indicated in blue, visual management. And I need to change the leads here, my DMM. In this case, I'm gonna use the, yeah, he knows. So I'm gonna do DC current. Yep. Very good. So now I'm sending 1 amp, reading 1 amp and 1. And the same. 2 amps. Two, spot on. This meter goes up to 10 amps. Be careful because this unit goes to 30 amps. Don't break it. If you exceed the current, you're gonna be breaking the fuse. For 5 amps, I need to change the post here in my calibrator. Then I send 5 amps and I'm getting 4.999. which is common and good. That'd be doing more points up to 10 amps, which is the last one. Yeah, 10.00, I'm good. Next, I'll be jumping to AC current. So 1 amp, 60 hertz. I need to check the post, yeah. Change to AC, then sending 1 amp, 60 hertz, 0.9991, 1, I waited, then 5 amps, 60 hertz, I need to change the post again, My calibrator will tell me which post I need to use, so pay attention to the lights. 5 amps, good. Yes. Perfect, 5. Then last point, 10 amps in this case. And I'm done. So the purpose of calibrating a DMM is basically comparing a known source with my unit under test to check if I have an error and how much is the error and how that my unit is performing on the field. So that's basically comparing a known value with an unknown value, and that's what calibration is. Well, that's it. If you have any questions, go to fluke.com and we will be happy to help.